In an age where being original is rare and authenticity is precious, in a city that never sleeps and a host to the world, you will find a group that creativity and authenticity is common like a cup of coffee. Rebranding is a marketing strategy in which a new name, term, symbol, design, or combination thereof is created for an established brand with the intention of developing a new, differentiated identity in the minds of consumers, investors, and competitors. That's the textbook definition, but to creatives, it's much more.
Essentially taking a brand, a product, a company's image, and refreshing it, modernizing it, making it new.
It's like a redreaming of your company. It's not literally launching a company, but it's just taking all you've collected and just like rethinking it all over again.
The generations change, consumer preferences change, and companies need to adapt. You know, they need to adapt to what's going on in the market today.
Basically doing day one with it, but not just showing everything you did create before that. The creative process, it's really, it's basically us just powering ourselves differently. We think of many different outlets. We think of everything that we shouldn't do and everything that we want to do.
And essentially, you know, dig into their minds, you know, and really get to know the company.
And like build that way. It's really us taking our time, not forcing anything.
It's not about us sitting down and okay, let's create something based on our own likes.
We actually try our best to like do different exercises, different methods of how to be creative and be original with whatever comes with this rebranding or anything that comes to us.
And really getting a feel for the services and the products and what the company offers. You really get energized by the day-to-day operations.
When it comes to rebranding, we must use that lightning that started the brand and recharge it.
We want to make sure that we get the essence and the aesthetics of what they want us to deliver. We don't want to destroy what they want. We don't want to make us like, oh, this is what you should do. It's basically tell us what you want and let's take it to the next level.
What they're looking for, the history of the company, the vision of the company, where it's going. We really take that into account because at the end of the day, they're the ones that really have the passion. And one thing that we always try to do is that we really try to get into that passion. We want to live that passion. You know, we want to live what they feel because that's the best way to really get the whole rebranding process, you know, to getting, you know, getting it done and really being successful at it.
Examples of like rebranding and being creative, if you can look at even Coca-Cola, you know, Pepsi, even American Airlines,
American Express, Apple, in fact, Exxon does it, Target. They've, you know, all these companies have, you know, existed for so many years in the market, and yet they rebrand, you know, and they modernize their image and they change, you know, sometimes the colors, sometimes, you know, the message, the slogan.
Us, we do a lot of rebranding with our clients, and one of the ones that we did that we actually really enjoyed was LA Riverside, and that was probably one of the most funnest campaigns we actually did rebranding wise, because she allowed us to do everything for her.
So far we have gotten great feedback from our clientele, but most importantly from other business owners. Other business owners have felt that, wow, you did the right thing.
The company has been around for, you know, more than 20 years. So it wasn't a simple task as to just, okay, let's create a new logo for them and that's it. You know, we really had to get in there and dig in to where this company comes from.
There's a saying in New York, if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. They never talk about how hard it is to make it or what to do, just to make it?
They came with us to rebrand them completely.
Basically, every step.
Branding the name. What does it mean? Who are you? Where are you located? So for me, it was very important to set the pace for other businesses, but also to bring a brand new sort of technology.
They wanted an updated logo, a website, a whole corporate image that they felt like they needed to do to keep up with their competition.
It's just a simple day-to-day kind of transactions that we do for our industry. The taxi drivers in the city of New York, they require something simple, easy to remember, but something that really translates to their needs. So in order for us to do that, the people that I have used in the last 20 years have never accomplished all of them together. I had to hire 5 different kind of people, you know, one for the internet, one for the page, one for the simple ad, one for to place the ad, but I was never able to find someone who can put all of them together. And I don't have to deal with 3, 5, 10 different people in 5, 10 different costs. Building my business from scratch, and that's basically what I found in Creative Capital.
The hardest thing of this campaign is so funny, because you would think that is the simplest. It was actually the logo. It was actually updating and modernizing the logo, because originally we made a few concepts. You know, we sat with the creative director and, you know, they came up with a few options for Mrs. Angeles, for the client. And, you know, we were so sure that, like, okay, this is the route that they're gonna go. This looks amazing. I mean, this, we're gonna hit it, you know, out the ballpark with this. And lo and behold, it was totally, you know, opposite of what the client was looking for.
I thought it was going to be more difficult to translate my message, my vision, and also to put in simple words what our businesses had done for the taxi and livery industry in the city of New York.
Maybe us trying to take it too far, we try to push it way to the future, and we really kind of almost like destroyed the history of the company. And but luckily, like, you know, we had to, like, halfway through the whole process, we stopped and made sure we were keeping up with everything that she wanted, and we realized that we were actually, like, almost gearing ourselves to take over the company instead of her being the owner and having this new image.
We did have a difficult moment, I believe, when we were at the Brooklyn Bridge, and the ad came out very nice. Nobody knows that it was, like, frozen out there, but working with professionals, you don't even remember that as a bad situation. Actually, it turned out to be a real fun experience for me.
We feel definitely so excited when the client, you know, when you see that smile in the client, it really gives us a lot of satisfaction, because, you know, it tells us that, you know, good job. We got the job done. We got the task done. The client is super happy.
We want to blow anyone that comes into our office, anyone that comes with us to an objective. We want to take it to the next level, and then from there find the next realm or the next world completely away from where it was originally.
Always wanted to excel in giving the clients much more than what they need, and really, you know, going to 101% in every single thing that we do.
And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem. All of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry.